I am from IGOPnet, which is a partner in the project Peer-to-Peer Value. And we have organized this CAPSSI Infoday in collaboration with the other CAPSSI projects in Barcelona. This session is going to be based on presentation of these CAPSSI projects, which is Peer-to-Peer Value, that I will present myself, then Dcent, that David Laniado will present. Then CONFINE, which CONFINE is not a CAPSSI project, but it's like previous to CAPSSI, and it's in the same kind of soul, I would say. And Leandro Navarro will present, and also Monica Garriga, which is another project called Citizens Square Kilometer. It's part of CONFINE, will also give us a test. And then we have two not yet funded European projects, but still very interesting local initiatives, which will present Mercè. Mercè Botella from Connexió, and then our local poster, which I would like very much to thank, which is FabLab, that Tomas, Diez will explain us. And after Tomas' presentation, we will have answers and questions. Well, actually, after each project presentation, if you have a straightforward question, you can ask. Otherwise, the general debate is going to be at the end of the whole presentation. I will act also as moderator, because the moderator couldn't come at the very end, so I am going to be presenting but also moderating. And so the goal of this panel is to give you an overview of already projects, and particularly to reflect on two trends that CAPSSI want to promote. On the one hand, the question of decentralization. How far the centralized infrastructure is already part of the social innovation, collaborative production ecosystem, and also how far these kind of projects can keep can be open and can also scale up, maintaining decentralization and openness. So, in the presentation of the project, we will point about these two principles which CAPSSI call want to promote. The hashtag of the session is CAPSSI, so if you want to interact through Twitter or make also questions through Twitter, please do. So now I have changed my hat and I am okay, so peer-to-peer value. So I will present the peer-to-peer value project, which it was funded under not exactly CAPSSI goal, but it's considered a CAPSSI project. And here you have the team and the different partners taking part of it. So the peer-to-peer value project is based on developing a platform which allows collaborative production. And in order to do that, we have a very big part of the project is about investigating practices of collaborative production. We adopt the concept of common-based peer production, which is a type of social innovation that tends to happen through supported through a platform on the internet. And so we have a very big program of researching collaborative production on the internet in order to support the design of a technological platform based on decentralized infrastructure that is being released with the project. And we developed this work through the principles of Lean, meaning that we have a very circular kind of development, in the sense of we start doing research, then we analyze the results of the research in the empirical field, and we apply them into design guidelines. The design guidelines for technological development could apply to any other project that is developing a platform, not only us, but also we apply it for the technological development part of the project, which is being based on at the moment of developing an implementation of Google Drive real-time API over a decentralized private infrastructure. Samuel Hassan from University Complutense of Madrid is coordinating the technological development, and if you have questions, he can also provide more in detail. After the research informed the technological development, we also make a test with the communities. So at the moment, we have a check with several communities, the Open Knowledge Foundation in France, we make in Milan, Garantia in Madrid, very different type of communities that are trying our platform. And on the base of the feedback, we restart the cycle and develop research and reinform the technological development. Regarding research, we have a very multidisciplinary approach, and we have developed at the moment four type of methodologies. On the one hand, we develop a mapping of common basic production in which we build a sample of 300 cases and analyze data, a statistical analysis of some features of these cases, like when did they start, which type of collaboration they are in, which governance models do they have, which strategies of sustainability do they have. And this end up being the larger, actually, data set on observations of common base reproduction. The data sets have 50,000 observations of common base reproduction. This is an outcome of the project in itself, which is based on open data. And with this data, we have been investigating which would be the conditions of success of collaborative production, meaning which are the type of cases that tend to be more able to generate value. We have investigated this through this data set of statistical analysis. Also, we have done surveys to cases of collaborative production. We have done digital ethnography, combining qualitative and quantitative approach, and also technolegal analysis of the cases. So all of this big program of research through different methodologies has informed the technological development of the project, looking into incorporating the design of the technology, which are the design features that tend to characterize the success cases in some way. We have paid particular attention to questions of governance, sustainability, and systems of reward, and how these can relate to value creation. So I will provide some basic results of the research. So what characterizes common base field production? First, we define it a set of dimensions of criteria of delimitation of collaborative production. Because collaborative production, there is already 20 years that we can identify cases on the internet, from using it to many cases on the internet that has is characterized as collaborative production, and there is a big expansion of it. But we need delimitation criteria in order to understand what would be common basic production in contraposition of, for example, new forms of market innovation. There are cases that actually make the question of Airbnb or cases like mechanical Turk, how far those are cases that are more characterized as market innovation or can be characterized as common base build production. It depends. There are very different different type of cases and also cases that are in the border, and we define this delimitation criteria in order to help us understand the expansion of collaborative production. So on the one hand, there should be cases that are should be collaborative in the sense of there should be more than two people involved, and there should be a collaborative production in the sense of there should be something out of the process that was not at the starting of it. The second criteria of delimitation for our cases is that it should be based on peer-to-peer relationships. And peer-to-peer relations refer, on the one hand, that they are not based on traditional command, someone like having a working contract and your boss can tell you what to do, but there are other types of organization of the task distribution, and there is also a limited mercantile exchange. This means that there might be some monetary exchange out of the part of the process, but this is very limited in order to explain the activity happening in there. Last, there should be a common resource out of it, in the sense of the resulting outcome of the process, of the production process, should be common in terms of many, this is reflected in the type of license that favor open access, reproducibility, or derivativeness. So on the basis of these criteria, we have been mapping collaborative production, and we identified 400, more than 400 cases. And in order to map in collaborative production, we have done it actually in a collaborative manner, in the sense of we built a directory, which is an open resource. We put some cases, but also other people we don't know actually also have incorporated cases to the directory. You can go there, you can download the database of cases, you can also consult the data and the features of each of the cases. For example, the type of license that they use, the type of platform, or which country they are based. We have investigated which is the actual area of activity of each of the cases, and we have identified 33 areas of activity. So if we all of us know like flows, like free and open source kind of projects, they are very well known, which are the brown area, are the biggest area. So the free and open source type of projects, which were the first kind of cases in which the model of common basic production start to appear, they still are the biggest part of the sample. So I'm referring to this brown area. But then also we identified that there are many other areas of activity that they are not as big as that, those ones, but are getting their ground. For example, there is sensor networks, there are Internet of Things, there are design, there are urban commons, there are peer-to-peer funding, open science. So there are many areas of activities based on common basic production which are adopting this model. So for us, it's more than thinking of common basic production is just an area of in which some type of products are being produced. It's actually a model of production that is becoming the reference in a large set of areas. Second, we have also analyzed from our sample, we have analyzed the relationship between the cases. So in this sample that we have in development statistical analysis, we apply network analysis in order to identify which are the cases that are central or which are the trends. And we have come up with several interesting things. For example, that the cases that has more are more linked, that are the balls that are biggest, are actually licensed. So the Creative Commons license or new license. This is telling us that the common basic production ecosystem, the institutions or the resources that most of the cases are related to are the license. They are very central in the ecosystem. We also have identified clusters of cases in the sense of you will notice that there is an area in which there are many cases that tend to have many interlinks between them. This area, we call it wiki industrial area, because there is like a distribution of different cases that tend to provide similar type of resources. For example, there is a big interlink between Wikipedia, WikiHow, WikiTravel, like cases that are similar between them, and they split the type of activities they develop. Another interesting result is that if we analyze the type of domain of the cases, for example, if the domain is .info, .org, or .org, we also realize that the .com cases tend to be very peripheral. So the ones that are in less dark, strong blue are peripheral to the area. So the .org or .info or .dev are much more central. This is another element of the non-mercantile character of this type of production. Regarding how value creation functions in common base with production, this is a very complex question, because this helps us to understand the successful cases. So which are the successful cases, the cases that actually develop value? But what is actually value in common base with production, when common base with production is characterized by very limited presence of money? There are very few activities that this actually happen through money exchange, or when traditional theories of value, like the price, does not apply to common base with production. It's not through price system, it's not through paying that you access to this type of production. So this applies to a real necessity to develop dimensions and indicators of value creation in common base with production. And this is what we have been doing in peer-to-peer value project. We have been developing a conceptual analytical framework to understand value in common base with production, also through researching what actually is present in the communities. And we have provided these five dimensions of value in common base with production, in the sense of if the case develop big community. This refers to the level of participation. If there is many people participating in itself, or there are many interrelations between the community, in itself this is valuable. The second element is if the case actually is able to achieve its mission. If the mission is to do a hub lab, like a fab lab, like the one that we are here, if it's been achieved, that's something that is valuable also. Monetary value. Even if, as I say, there is very limited monetary exchange in common basic production, still the level of budget of the case is also an indicator of values. And the last two is social use, how far the resource that is being produced by the case is being used and adopted, and how far it's reputated. So we have been investigating these five dimensions of value. What we have found out is that the dimension of the community is very diverse. There is not a typical range of community scale, but what is present in most of the cases is that there is what is known as power law, referring that there is very different degrees of involvement. There is the tendency of 1% of people with a strong involvement, a 9% weak involvement, and a 90% of lookers or non-involvement. This is known as power law, and we actually identify this also in the sample. Second, in terms of mission accomplished, we have realized that actually the projects are quite satisfied. In a scale up to 10, half of the projects point themselves at 7. So the cases are actually half satisfied about the level of accomplished their mission. So common base with production is a model of production that seems to be working for the cases that are trying to put it in practice. In terms of the monetary value, we identify that actually the budget of the cases tend to be very low. 39% of the cases has a budget of less than 1,000 euros, and still they are satisfied with accomplishing their mission. So again, monetary exchange is not a dimension that helps to understand the common base production. Another element regarding reputation and social use, in order to measure the level of reputation of the cases, we identify a limitation is that all the indicators of reputation, like for example, Google page rank, Alexa, create Twitter followers or Facebook likes. We have been collecting data for the 300 cases on these indicators of reputation, but the problematic is that all of them are corporate, all of them, which is fine. But what is problematic is that all of them are closed, so they are not transparent. We don't know the algorithm. We don't know why they make reputative, they make a lot of reputation for Facebook pay rank of a case and not another. So a conclusion of the peer-to-peer value research is that there is a real need of developing indicators of reputation on the web that are based on free and open source license. Nevertheless, something we also identified is that there is a very big, very strong correlation between the indicators of reputation. So if you are good in Facebook, you are going to be good in Google PageRank or in Alexa. They tend to be very coherent between them. In terms of governance, of the analysis of the governance of the collaborative common based production cases, first conclusion is that common based production tend to be highly open. We develop, we define an index of openness, and at least 50% of the cases are in a scale of 10 are in a position of 6. So they are very open. So this is a characteristic that somehow it's been achieved by common based production, even if they are very diverse in the way they are open. They are also highly free. 77% of the cases have two of three indicators of freedom. And here, by freedom, we refer to the registration policy, referring that you can register without needing the permission of no one else. You have automatic registration, or there is anonymous participation allowed. There is freedom in terms of the user profile policy, for example. If you can control the information that is about yourself in your profile. So we took indicators of freedom in common based production, and also it ended up that they are very, tend to be very, favor a lot of freedom. Some of them, like 63%, also favor, are based on self-governance, referring that the community of people involved can define their norms and the regulation that involve the interaction. But they are also very hierarchical, in the sense of that 80% of the cases actually have hierarchies referring to different degrees of user accounts. So there are some accounts that has power to do things that not everybody has. And this refers to accounts which are administrators of the site, or accounts that can block other users. So it's very common, as I say, 88% of the cases has different a structure of different power dimensions in the type of account. In terms of the gender balance in these different kind of power positions, it's not as bad as previous literature has pointed. At least 25% of the cases, there is a 55% of female administrators. But what we in our analysis find that is the